about a Tolkien's journey. We'll be doing some story missions, TFLs. Just some general grinding Star Trek. Let's go.
Security teams report to docking base 6. Security teams, report to Docking Bay 6.
Very low. I have to change that. Setting. Thank you. Is that better, Estonian? Can you hear me, Estonian? So, anyway, how are you, Estonian?
Good, you made it. I wasn't looking forward to dealing with this by myself. Our hollow emitters are doing their job, and the bombings should happen soon. Once that's finished, we can get started. I brought some remodulators. Once you've equipped one, we can drop the holo shield and get moving. Daniel said this might happen. Something to do with the effect of chronoton flux on short-term memory. You gotta love temporal mechanics. Been sent back in time to fix a problem. It's April 4th, 2063, the day before first contact. This is the missile complex where humanity's first warp-capable vessel was launched. The Borg are the problem. They're here, and they're trying to change history in their favor. History says the Borg failed because of Picard and the crew of the Enterprise, but as of now, history's wrong. Somehow the Borg managed to pull victory from the jaws of defeat tonight. We're here to make sure that doesn't happen. Right now, we're effectively invisible inside this holo shield. Once we're ready to move out, we'll drop it and our personal emitters will kick in. Think of them as a sophisticated disguise kit. They'll make us look like we belong here. To the locals, we'll look like a band of 21st century humans wandering around the woods of Montana. Any other questions? Daniel said this might happen. The Borg are the problem. They're here. Okay, the bombing should end quickly thanks to the Enterprise. We're gonna need to move fast once things stop exploding. Don't forget to equip a frequency remodulator. Let's get moving. We need to get to the complex quickly. So much for the bombing run. Enterprise must have finished off the Borg vessel.
We are the Borg. Your biological and technological distinctiveness will be added to our own. Resistance is futile.
After all this time, they still haven't learned. Resistance is inevitable.
Thank you.
Complex took some hits. Let's check for survivors. I'm not picking up any Borg life signs in the complex. The Cardinus people should be here now. Let's make sure before we move on.
No problem.
Okay, my tricorder's picking up multiple subspace comm signals in the area. Some of them are Starfleet, but they're coming from inside the missile silo. Probably protecting Zefram Cochran. The rest of the signals are coming from the southwest. Got it in one. Looks like they managed to send down a few landing parties before their ship blew up. Chances are they're here to make our lives difficult. I think it's time we return the favor. Up, there are drones ahead.
Your defenses are insufficient. You will be assimilated.
There are lights over there. Looks like a camp of some kind. Borg will be drawn to it like moths to a flame. We need to protect the locals. Picking up life signs ahead. Some of them are Borg.
Well, what do you want? Get away from us!
You will be assimilated. You will adapt and serve the collective.
What the hell are those things? Robots? Zombies? Robot zombies?
Spray something with you. Take out those drones. Do a memory wipe. They can't remember the Borg. Setting your tricorder to emit a neurolytic pulse should work.
Okay, Esther. Nice to see you come back.
Looks like the Borg have changed their tactics. They're avoiding Cochran and the Enterprise crew and focusing on assimilating the locals. Makes sense. After they lost their ship, they lost their numerical advantage. argument here. I ran a quick scan of these drones. There's several references in their onboard nav systems to a location north of here. Designation Resource Node 01. We should check this out. Whatever they're up to isn't a good... All right, this area's clear. Picking up Borg signals to the north, though. Apparently, Resource Node 01 is a garbage dump. Sounds wonderful. There must be something of tactical value to it. Let's make sure they don't find it. Great. This place smells and it's swarming with drones. Take them down. Figure out what they were looking for here. Power amplifiers. Copper tubing. And lithium batteries. Oh, hell. I think I know what they're doing here, and it's not good. Fair point. I think they're trying to build a transporter. They might have lost their ship, but there's a lot of Borg still on Enterprise. If they can beam those drones down here, this situation will go from bad to worse. Complex isn't far. Let's make sure it's secure and then work on finding and dealing with this bootleg transporter. Sign of the Borg. Run a scan, make sure Picard's team is all accounted for. Picking up Starfleet comm badges inside the bar and... Hold on. More Starfleet comm badges inbound, but they're on Borg drones. Say the Borg finished making their transporter. Those were assimilated Starfleet officers from Enterprise. Let's sweep the perimeter and make sure there aren't any Borg going after Cochrane. Okay, the perimeter's clear. I'm thinking that transmission tower is our next stop.
Joy.
Bootleg Borg transporter. We need to take it out before this place is crawling with drones. There are three transporter pads. Each of them is powered by an array. I can send a feedback pulse from each array to the transporter pad it powers. It should be enough to overload and destroy the pad. Yeah, there's that. You're gonna need to keep them off me while I work, or this plan will go sideways real fast. After we're taking care of the transporter pads, we'll deal with any drones in the area. And if we're lucky, that'll take care of this temporal crisis once and for all. Let's cross that bridge when we come to it, okay? Right now, we have a transporter to shut down. Ready to do this?
I need a drink first. Committing suicide is not normally on a day-to-day basis. But of course, as a Starfleet officer, it's something you just have to do occasionally.
Get me to the first array and I'll start disabling their transporter.
First we have to get to the first array.
They're using a simple modulating cell. All right, this one's done. Let's go.
I think I'm scared.
Two to go. Stay sharp. They know we're up. Remember the part about keep them off me? Yeah, do that now. They're onto us. Security protocols just spiked, and not in a good way.
Yeah. Good time.
Two down. That last one's gonna be a real bitch. Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this.
Yeah.
Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this. Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this. Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this.
Flanking damage detected. Crystal shield losing power.
Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this. Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this.
Flanking damage detected.
Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this. Only one left. Stay with me. We can do this.
We have analyzed your tactics. We have adapted. We are important.
Fractal self-replicating security. Got it. The transporter's out of view. I think we're through the worst of it. I'm not picking up any Borg activity in the area. Nice work. Over, as far as you're concerned. I'll deal with all this Borg tech lying around. It's a mess, but my nanites will make short work of it. As for you, feel free to return to the present. Take a break, have a drink. You've definitely earned it.
Get out of here, guys.
I'm currently on leave from Voyager, and I was...
Did that also help my endeavors? Or am I still...
I'm currently on leave from Voyager, and I was passing near the Hobus system in a shuttlecraft when I picked up some odd energy readings. I took a detour to investigate. You know, you can't be too careful where Hobus is concerned. But I wouldn't mind some help. Can you rendezvous with me at these coordinates? Having a real starship here would be a big help.
I accept your quest.
There's something going on.
Federation shuttle Tereshkova. I am under attack in the Hobus system, requesting emergency assistance. I'm under attack by Romulan vessels. I could use a little help here. I'm a decent pilot, but things are getting a little rough. This freighter's packing some serious weapons. I don't think they're hauling cargo.
This is the Romulan Imperial Star Navy. You are in a restricted area. Leave immediately.
They're Imperial Royalists.
Hey,
sending out some strange readings and discovered this errant freighter. I hailed them and they opened fire. It's a good thing you picked up my distress signal. Thanks for the assistance. I was checking out some strange readings and discovered this air. I don't know yet. Based on these ships' identification codes, these aren't Tal Shiar vessels, just elements of the old Romulan Star Navy. They're no friends of the intelligence agencies, but also not allies of the Republic. Last true sons of the Empire, that sort of thing. Not to impose, but my shuttle's taken a beating. Do you mind if I bring it aboard? Our last mission wasn't easy. We made it through in one piece, but afterwards, it seemed like a good time to use my personal leave. I'll rejoin Voyager in a few weeks.
This is Lieutenant Gaius Salong. This vessel has been disabled. Your interference is disruptive, but survivable. This unit is executing its priority directives. All other directives have been suspended. This unit was defending this vessel against outside attack. Defense of associates is required by priority override.
Help much. They must be trying to gain access to the gateway data. There's a door to the left. Through the side door and down to the gate. I surrender. Well, no. I do still have crucial information about your poor friend, Lieutenant Ceylon, and how to fix his addled Borg brain. About the gateways and how to use them. About the Iconians. Now tell me. Aren't those things more important than the fleeting pleasure you'll get from shooting me?
A bit.
But you are interested in what I can tell you. This gateway is damaged beyond repair, but I learned a thing or two when I was a guest of the Iconians. I know how to operate their gateways, and I've memorized several sets of coordinates. I know about places you haven't seen yet. In fact, the only reason I was here was to open a gate to a specific Iconian base. Do you really think there are only two Dyson spheres? There are more, and I know the location of the one the Iconians are still using. Wouldn't you like to see that?
I've received some distressing news, and I need to update your mission orders. Your communications officer tells me you're not aboard your ship. What's your status?
No, please. Go ahead. I can wait.
We've received word that Sela has escaped from Republic custody and that she was last seen in the Devron sector. Be aware that she was apparently aided in her escape by Lieutenant Gaius Salon, a Republic intelligence officer. Republic intelligence thinks she has some kind of information about the Iconians that she hasn't shared yet. This is a little odd, but let's give her a little leash. Stay close and find out what you can. See if you can determine her plans. Be prepared to bring her in if she shows any signs of endangering anyone.
Well, well, well. Keep your friends close and your enemies closer, isn't that the saying? I'll make you a deal. You want Gaius back, and you want to learn what I know? I'm willing to give you both. But first, we'll need to discuss the deal aboard my ship. Don't worry. I'm sure your crew will keep a transporter lock and whisk you away at the first sign of danger. Enjoy having the upper hand for as long as it lasts.
I suppose we don't have much choice. Whenever you're ready, we can beam up to Sela's ship. But I'll go with you and watch your six.
I know you're not inclined to believe me, but I am telling the truth. I do have coordinates to a sphere the Iconians are still using. The Iconians have many servants. Some, like the Alachi, you have already seen. I watched how they opened the gateways and memorized the coordinates. The Iconians are moving their soldiers and ships into position. One day, soon, they'll be right on our doorstep. This is our one chance to find out what the Iconians are doing and when they're going to attack. And they won't wait for our ships to be in position or give us time to muster a defense. One day very soon, the Iconians will simply appear at our homeworlds, and we will have to fight to survive. Poor Gaius. All that Borg hardware in his head made it easy to give him some guidance. I've had quite a bit of time to learn about Borg technology. All you need to know is which switches to flip. It's been very helpful having someone on the inside. I would have never escaped without him. But as a gesture of goodwill, I'll give him back now. There probably won't be any permanent damage. The Tal Shiar has studied mind control for decades, and I had full access to their techniques. Some of it is quite ingenious. Do you know that the proper sequence of mental conditioning and image projection can program someone to kill their best friend? I've seen it work. Once you know how to get into someone's head, you're there forever. With the coordinates I've memorized, I can gain access to an Iconian staging sphere. Tapping into the Iconian data networks is risky, but the potential benefits are significant. It will be difficult. Iconian operating systems are designed to overwrite and destroy other computers. However, I know enough about their devices to gain some useful information before that happens. Specifically, we need to determine what forces the Iconians will use against us. We must prepare for what's coming. My engineers report that they're having trouble keeping engine power stable. It appears you did quite a bit of damage to my ship. Unrelated systems keep failing in no discernible pattern. Perhaps you can take some of your people down to the engine room and have a look? Keep in mind that the sooner we get underway, the sooner this is all over. This freighter was armed by loyal Romulan Imperial officers and citizens who realized that a lone freighter would be easy prey for any space pirate. In addition, the Romulan Navy offered protection to this ship with some of the few warbirds remaining in their fleet, some of which you destroyed. these people follow me because they believe in the rebirth of the Romulan Empire. A proud empire that can hold its head high and be a force to be reckoned with among the stars. They follow me because I can lead them there. Many Romulans died for the hope of a new future. I won't let their sacrifices be in vain. Whatever the fate of the Romulan people, I am determined to ensure that our legacy is never extinguished from this galaxy. I regret every death of every loyal Romulan. But I will honor their loss by fighting for those who still survive. We share an interest. We have a galaxy to protect.
This unit is in diagnostic mode. This unit is responding to its neural overrides. Please, help me.
My ship down there. Don't make things worse.
Bomb. I shouldn't need to remind you that we're on a timetable, so I won't.
Well, unless you want to go for fucking long voyage on a ship that goes nowhere. Or if you want to get spaced.
You? You have to help me. I'm a Republic intelligence operative on deep cover. I infiltrated this crew of Romulan naval officers because they were still loyal to Sela. We can recapture her if we can keep this ship disabled. Sela is using you. She'll never tell you anything of substance. If she was the Iconian's prisoner, she couldn't have seen anything important. If she's still working with them, then she's leading you into a trap. Your only chance is to capture her now and help us reveal anyone in the Republic who helped her escape.
I understand you've captured a saboteur. I won't tolerate a threat to the safety of this mission and my crew. I intend to have him executed immediately. Very well. However, this still doesn't solve our problem. We need to find a working Iconian gate. The Nopata system? Interesting. My ship has been modified to mask its energy signature, so we should be able to get there without detection. The Tal Shiar may be a problem, though. The Tal Shiar serves the Iconians now. Certain elements of the Imperial Navy are still loyal, but the Tal Shiar would be more inclined to shoot me than listen to me.
Those are Tal Shiar ships. The Star Navy doesn't have the interest or the means to police far-flung systems like this one. The Tal Shiar and I don't exactly see eye to eye these days, so feel free to do what you will.
Enemy vessel. This system is under Tal Shiar control. Stand down and prepare to be boarded.
Hakeev's private research facility. Soon all this will be lost to the sand. What a monument to folly. The Tal Shiar commonly use a diverter to intercept standard access codes on electronic locks. Give me just a moment. There. You really should learn some of these things.
Yeah, but if we did that, we wouldn't need to bring you along, would we? Which means I could have then just shot you in the head and left you to die.
Someone else has been through here recently. Tal Shiar!
Yeah, it's Tal Shiar.
Why am I not surprised the mess hall is the one place here that isn't a total wreck? At least they were smart enough to take the weapons out of the armory.
Thank you. couple of them are stony.
Hakiv Sanctum. I'm guessing that side door isn't just for show.
There must be a way through this blank wall. Maybe there's a release trigger in the office.
Allow me. Computer, recognize identity Sela, code Empress 1. Unlock lab access. Always have a back door. Another secret door. Hakiv was always so melodramatic.
Secret door, facing. Door for door for door.
You're getting a little too close to the truth. It's time to eliminate you both.
You should be more careful about the loyalty of your subordinates. Stop her! Don't let her escape!
Kill it!
There we go. I'll just put in those coordinates.
Hello, James.
Hurry up! They'll find us soon.
No shit, Sailor. Not like we just didn't use one of their gateways to get here.
Good. There's a gateway on this side. We won't be stuck here. Now, let's see what secrets we can wrest from this facility.
You!
Taurus. Stop her! Automated defenses? What a waste of time. Get that force field down! We need to catch her before she can cause any more trouble. She's locked the door. Try to unlock it with one of these consoles. Interesting. According to this data, we're in the galaxy. You should download some of these files to your tricorder. This sphere seems to be much older than the others. There's communication traffic from Iconian ships inside the sphere. I've never seen these kinds of vessels before. Here we go. Almost there. Got it. The door is open. Taurus must have overloaded the collimators in that plasma. There's nowhere left to run, Taurus. Do you really think the Iconians will help you now?
No, you don't understand. I didn't seek them out because I wanted to rule. I needed them to save us, to turn back time, to undo Hobus, and bring back Romulus.
Then you're more of a fool than I thought. You poor, deluded creature. The Iconians aren't interested in saving anything. Nor could they.
We have to get out of here. It's not safe anymore. They're coming.
I guess you'd better go then. If you had only known, Taurus, the Iconians can't travel through time. It destroys their minds. The sphere just jumped. Look, it's nighttime inside this sphere, but it's never dark inside the other spheres. The Iconian fleets are here, and there are so many ships they're blotting out the sun.
I see you.
Time to go.
Uh-oh.
How absurd to think that she could have ever accomplished anything significant. She lost her throne and spent years in mindless devotion to gods who could not hear or answer her prayers. Taurus's fanaticism blinded her. She studied everything about the Iconians, but never learned the one simple fact that would have ended her quest. There was only one thing she didn't get wrong. We need to leave immediately. Iconian minds aren't like ours. They're entangled with Chronoton states. I'll spare you the boring details. It helps to orient them when using their gateways, but it means that they can't go back and forth in time like we can. Doing so would cause the Iconian to lose its memories of the intervening time. Take a look at the sky. In a sphere like this, nothing should obscure the sun. Those aren't clouds. Did you feel that? The sphere just jumped. The Iconian invasion is beginning.
You were warned. Your galaxy is forfeit.
It's a herald, the personal guards and servants for the Iconians. Fighting is not our best option. Head for the gate. Run!
Already one step ahead of you.
The gateway is destabilizing. I'll take care of this. Jump through, now!
Thank you.
It's good to have you back. A Dyson sphere jumped into a position near the Iconia system less than an hour ago. We don't know anything about it, but based on the preliminary notes you've logged, we think it's the same sphere that you discovered with Sela. I hate to admit it, but she was right. The Iconian invasion is here. There's no sign of Sela, incidentally. We'll keep looking, but I have a feeling she won't be found until she wants to be. And as long as she stays away, I'm inclined to let her go. She'll have to answer for her crimes someday, but we have much more immediate concerns.
That is true. No, we do.
Attacks from the Iconian forces are imminent. Their gateway technology means that distance has little meaning for them. Once the war begins in earnest, we will be racing to cover too much territory with too few ships. But we cannot fail. To fight a war, we first need a plan. Admiral Quinn has requested your presence at a briefing on Earth space dock.
We've detected an anomaly in the Azure.
Fuck that. I hit the wrong thing. I didn't want to go to the Alpha. God for fucking hell. Same. If I can just try to. Like I should have been able to do the answer. I hope everyone's having a nice day or night. Thank you for joining me. Let's get this mission underway, hey? Oh, hiccup.
Welcome. And thank you for coming. We've gathered here the finest commanders from Starfleet, the Klingon Defense Force, and the Romulan Republic. We may have been enemies in the past. Now, we must fight as one. May I introduce Captain Cogran? He will coordinate our combined forces against the Iconians and report to the commanders of all three fleets.
Greetings. The Iconians have revealed themselves. War. It's now inevitable. While the Iconians themselves are few in number, their heralds are numerous and formidable. They are not like the servitors we have fought before. They are far more dangerous. We are already sending strike teams into the sphere the heralds use to access the Iconian gateway network. They will retaliate. And when they do, they will attack our most valuable targets. The gateways allow the heralds to strike anywhere. They can avoid or destroy any obstacle in their path. Therefore, the Alliance has decided to focus on defending key installations. We need time to create a strategy. To that end, let me introduce Captain Tom Paris.
Hello, everyone. Okay, this is what we know about the weaknesses of the heralds. If we can exploit this, we can...
It's beginning.
It has begun.
Their goal appears to be New Romulus. The Federation has a starbase nearby. Captain Paris, take your task force and the bulk of the fleet to New Romulus. The rest of you, report to Starbase 234. Right now, that starbase is all that stands between the heralds and New Romulus. Hold the heralds there as long as you can. We need time to evacuate civilians and prepare defenses at New Romulus. Today is a good day to die.
No, I don't think so. I don't have to live. Living sounds better.
Herald ships on an intercept course. All ships, defend the starbase. I've never seen anything like these Herald ships before. There's too many of them. Begin evacuation procedure.
starting my run from the station.
They're coming through us. They're going to take place to get inside the defense perimeter. Jesus, no stopping them.
Harold's closing in. Defensive the maneuver.
Welcome to the war. The Romulans are asking for boots on the ground, but we've got more than we can handle up here. There are some weak spots in the Herald lines. If you can punch through to transporter range, you should be able to get a team down there to assist. Up. desperate on the surface. Good luck down there, and watch your back.
Lean down and help the Romulans on the ground. They're gonna be overwhelmed.
Thank you. Now that the area is secure, we can call in reinforcements. Subcommander Zylan is ready to lead a squad to assist you.
Defensive position in the ruins. sensors indicate Herald forces inbound to this position. We must hold here. hold the path. There's a camp near the power station. There will be reinforcements there.
I think we can take it from here. There's a gateway opening to the north. Opening to the north. To the north.
Flanking damage detected. Flanking damage detected.
Flanking damage detected.
way.
I'm a little busy here. What do you need? Acknowledged. Wouldn't want to miss the party. I'll get every ship with an operational warp drive headed that way as soon as New Romulus is secure.
The Iconians. I am not programmed for this line of inquiry. Would you like me to wake one of my creators? You can ask her all the questions you wish. Greetings, my child. Long have I slumbered. Why have you roused me now? Ah, the Iconians. They are the first of our children, and for a time, the most troublesome. They were different once, brighter. But our other children grew jealous of their gifts, and chafed against their rule. The war changed them more than they could understand. I will help you, my child. Hold. I sense her approach. Our daughter, Matara, comes. She is first among equals, and her rage is terrible to behold. Go. I will retrieve what you seek, if it is not already too late.
Damage detected.
cannot. I have been waiting for this day. We will reclaim all that was once ours. We will rule this galaxy, as is our right and our duty. None can stand against us. Not even you.
Not alone. The rest. They are not kidding around. Raise your shields. We need to hold out until the rest of the fleet arrives. More Herald ships. These guys just won't give up.
Action.
Pyrrhic victory. Is what it was? A Pyrrhic victory.
Although this is a dark day, you have served admirably. The loss of the Archive is regrettable, but the Preservers are not the only casualties this day. There will be more death before this war ends.
Fuck now.
Although this is a dark day, you have served admirably. The loss of the Archive is regrettable, but the Preservers are not the only casualties this day. There will be more death before this war ends. But those of us... Captain Tom Paris has requested your ship.
Okay, guys. Thank you for watching. This is where I'm gonna have to say goodbye. While I look for someone to raid, I'll do a headphones to enjoy the Edward. I'll look for someone to raid. And thank you guys for stopping by.